Welcome back to Tumangong Perspective. We still have Congressman Erin Tanyada. And on the phone, I'm hoping we still have Attorney Mones Guerra. Are you still there,
Mon? I am here, Adel.
Okay. Mon, let me get back to you. This fact, the fact that there are 8 justices of the Supreme Court who have, issued this TRO, I want to ask you again. You said you wanted to go to the Supreme Court much earlier, meaning at the first instance when you filed your motion for a preliminary hearing and it was denied. Could you tell us why? What was the discussion in the defense? Why you didn't go to the Supreme Court that early?
Well, we were able to convince Justice Cuevas that it may be too early in the stage of the proceedings to bring that matter up, even if we share his view that there is a jurisdictional issue there already based on our position then, and which is our still which is still our position now, that indeed the verified complaint was defective. Because it was filed in violation of the right of the Chief Justice to notice and hearing, no, as required. No, that's the position that the panel has taken primarily by Justice Cuevas. But at that point, we said that we cannot afford to be accused of delaying the proceedings and resorting to what may be perceived by the public to be a delaying tactic on our part, and so and we did not file any motion for reconsideration because that remedy is not available under the Senate rules. Yeah? So we went on believing that we can still have a fair and credible trial. And as I was stressing earlier, liberality has been given, and this was stressed again by the Senate President in this afternoon's trial. The Senate has been liberal. We have been liberal.
Mon, can I ask you on that point, on the point of liberality? Just a final word on your part, because you have, on behalf of the Chief Justice, you filed your petition before the Supreme Court, essentially asking to stop the proceedings. If you don't get the TRO from the Supreme Court, do you feel that you can still have a chance of getting justice here at the Senate Tribunal, when the arguments that I've been hearing from Justice Cuevas is that in some ways your hands are tied because you can't even make objections, and the Senate Tribunal, at least on the basis of your petition, has been overly liberal to the point of affecting the due process rights of the Chief Justice?
We take the position that the rights of the Chief Justice had been trampled upon in the course of the proceedings. These rights have been utterly violated to our mind now. If you're asking me whether or not we can still get justice from from the Senate Impeachment Tribunal, there is still that hope that we entertain at the moment, Adele. And because otherwise, if we don't have that hope, then there is no reason for us to stay and continue defending the Chief Justice anymore. So as we went into this trial, we believed in the institution that will try the Chief Justice as it is trying him now. And we believe that we should afford, and as we afford, respect to the institution. So in the process, no, the process, more than anything, it's the process, the impeachment process that we have gone into.
Okay, thank you, Mon. Well said. I'll give the final word to Congressman Erin Tanyada. Your thoughts as we move forward, do you believe that you've already laid the predicates? And do you think that even without these dollar accounts, that you have enough in your artillery to prove your charges against the Chief Justice?
We would like we would like to have the dollar accounts exposed, mm-hmm. because as a matter of fact, there's now this mindset by certain people that now we can hide our bank deposits in dollar accounts, and it will never be opened by the impeachment court. So we're now at a stage where public officials, mm-hmm. accountable at that, can now use this as an excuse to avoid liability from any agency or so. What is important right now is for us to, even for the Senate, to decide, will this issue remain hanging, or should we grab it at the horns and say, when it comes to public officials, there's this other exception that has to be inserted, even if it is not mentioned in the law. I would think that it would send a clear signal on accountability. We believe that we have done our part in Article 2, even in the worst case scenario, that the bank deposits, the U.S. bank, the dollar deposits are not exposed. We have a strong case, and we're ready to move forward to the other articles.